Okay, today we're going to talk about factoring trinomials. We have three terms. We have our first term, our ax squared term. We have a middle term, which is our bx term, and then our last term, which is a c term. Talking about trinomials where the first term, the coefficient a, doesn't equal 1. It's a little bit more of a challenge to factor these problems. It can be difficult. We're going to talk about how we can approach these problems to make it more doable. I mean, some people say, what is a doesn't equal 1? What does that mean? A can be 4 or 16, a can be 7, or any number that's not 1. And that presents a problem or a challenge. And we have an example here. One example we have is 2x squared plus 15x plus 28. We'll use this to go through the process. Now, a doesn't equal 1 equals 2. Now, how do we do? What do we do? First, we're going to multiply the a coefficient times c. So, a times c. Okay, now we have a times c equals 56, 2 times 28 that is. We have to find pairs, like factor pairs, that multiply to 56 but also add up to our middle term, 15. 56 has quite a few pairs. There's 1 and 56, 2 and 28, 4 and 14. But I've already picked two here. In our example, 7x and 8x, that when they add together, positive 7x and positive 8x, they become 15x. Watch here. No. Now what do I do? Okay. 2x squared plus 15x plus 28. We're going to look at the 15. We're going to change that. See what happens. Now, as you can see, I took the 15 and I split it into 8x plus 7x. I didn't divide it, but I just split it into two numbers when added together equal 15x. I didn't change or get rid of 15x. 15x is the same thing as saying 8x plus 7x. So now we have 2x squared, we'll bring that down, and 28, we'll bring that down as well. Okay, now a times c, we've done that already. Let's review what we the process. We found our pairs, picked the correct pair, 7 and 8, both being positive, they do add up to be 15x. We took our 15x, we split it into two terms, 8x and 7x. Now we're going to use a method called the grouping method for factoring. And what that means is this. We're going to focus on two terms at a time, separating them. So with the first two terms, we have 2x squared plus 8x. What do these two terms have in common? Well, they're both even. 2 can divide 2, and 2 can divide 8, both evenly. They both have the variable x, so we can pull out an x to the first power. We'll do that. See what happens. So now if I divided the first two terms by 2x, I would have x plus 4 left over on the inside. Now the second two terms, we have 7x and we have 28. What do they have in common? Well, they can divide 1. Okay, 7x and 28. 7 divided by 7 and 28 divided by 7. They both go in evenly. Okay. Seven x divided by 7 is x, and 28 divided by 7 is 4. Now, if you look at these now, we can see 2x times a quantity, x plus 4, plus 7 times the quantity, x plus 4. So now we can see a common factor. They both have the factor of x plus 4, and we can divide that out. And we'll see what it looks like when we're done. Here's what we have. This is completely factored now. X plus 4 times quantity 2x plus 7. Now, to verify that we're correct, we should multiply these two binomials and see if we go back to our original trinomial. We'll do that now. Now, our check has worked. Our multiplication and trinomial here at the bottom here matches our original trinomial, and that confirms that our answer, x plus 4 times 2x plus 7, is correct. And this is the correct answer. Okay. I have another example to show you that will complete the vlog. That's not what I wanted to do. Okay, I'm going to delete it. All right, now we have 2x squared minus 9x minus 5. Now our first step is to multiply the first term and the third term. A times c. Okay, let me clean that up there. So it's clear. 2 times negative 5 equals negative 10. Now, what I have to figure out is negative 10. Okay, it's going to be a negative product, so I need mixed signs. One positive, one negative. Okay, and the two factors need to add or sum to be negative 9. Okay, I had to clean that up. It didn't look very clear. Positive 1 times negative 10, negative 1 times positive 10. Now we have 2 and 5 with different signs, plus and minus, minus and plus. Okay. So now, which one works out to be negative 9? It's our first pair. So 2x squared, we split our middle term, 9x. I think I'm going to attempt the negative 10x first and the positive 1x next. Now, our first two terms, what's in common? That's our question. They're both even. I can divide by 2. And they both have an x within them to the first power, so I can pull out the x also. Now, our second two terms, positive 1 minus 5. Positive 1x and a negative 5. Now, it's a difficult one, or it seems difficult. We have 1x minus 5. Feels like there's nothing in common here. But we can always divide out a positive 1. It doesn't change the what's left inside, but we can still divide out a positive 1, and we'll see what happens. Now, what they have in common here, you should see that, is parentheses x minus 5. So let's see, let's pull that out and see what's left. This is our answer for this problem. X minus 5 times quantity 2x plus 1. I recommend you check it yourself, multiply it through, and it should work out to be the same answer. Thank you, and I'll see you next vlog.